Welcome from Overcomers Deliverance and Healing Ministry, Brampton, Toronto, Canada. I am going to talk to you the subject called I Declare Never Again of Frustration and Backwardness. There are powers called frustration and backwardness. This power, it has messed the life of many people. Frustration. Even Jesus himself with his disciples, when he went to the other side, he saw a multitude of crowd of people following him. And it was late in the evening. These people were with Jesus for 3 days. They were hungry. They need to eat something. And then Jesus told Philip, give these people something to eat. Philip was so frustrated and he was discouraged and like, Jesus, are you mocking me? What do you mean when you tell me like this? And then the disciples, they come together, they started talking. They said, what can happen? Why did Jesus telling us like this? Does Jesus grace? How can we feed these people, 5,000, excluding women and children? So the disciples started scratching their head and thinking what to do. Philip fell. Philip was not able to answer, and he started frustrated. And then eventually he saw a boy with the bread and fish. So he told Jesus, I only see a boy here with a few fish and bread, but this one is nothing. It cannot able to feed the people. Then Jesus told Philip, you still going to make these people sit 50 to 50. So Philip was still saying, now, like, let me do, because this is too much. How can he still telling me to tell the people sit 50-50 and we don't have food? What is this? What is this? But after the frustration, and then eventually the people were fed and everybody was happy and they were remaining 12 baskets of it. So I said there's some powers really can frustrate you at the moment, but because you don't know, you will continue in that box. You will continue frustrated. You will continue frustrated until you know what to do. If Philip knew that Jesus is able to deliver and provide, he could not even think of anything. If they could not say all those questions, immediately he could say, yes, Lord. But Philip said, you see, I already see a boy with the fish and few fish and few bread. And the disciples said, this can cost thousands of dollars to feed these people. They were negotiating and talking like you and me, like a human being can reason. But they didn't know that there was power behind Jesus who can multiply, who can deliver you, who can set free from the situation you are facing. Now, when you look at the book of Exodus 17, verse 3 to 4, the Bible says, but the people were thirst for water there, and they grumbled against Moses. They said, why did you bring us up out of Egypt to make us and our children and livestock die on thirst? Then Moses cried to the Lord, what am I to do with these people? They are almost ready to stone me. So now look at this. It was God who told Moses to take the children of Israel out of Egypt. It was God who made the in the wilderness the children of Israel saw the miracle. It was God who was talking to Moses face to face, ear to ear. And now here, Moses is being frustrated and going backward. Instead of going forward, he started crying. Don't cry of your problem. God who was speaking to Moses is the same God who could Moses say, God, here we are, please do your miracle. But Moses started crying, saying, people are going to stone me. Moses started crying. Yeah? Don't cry for your problem. You know God is able. God told Moses, don't cry. What do you have? Don't cry. And God told Moses, strike the rock upon all things. The rock that water can produce water. And the rock started producing water, and the people drink the water and their animals. But God was angry. Why people were complaining, murmuring, very rude to Moses. Frustration can really make you to go backward instead of going forward. But we thank God who does not change. Your God will never leave you. Just take a step of faith and condemn that frustration you are in, and tell that frustration in the name of Jesus Christ, I condemn you, I declare you never again. Because people been frustrated. They get very, very, very frustrated. Instead of going forward, they go backward now. You can't move. You are stagnant. You are stagnant. By the power in the blood of Jesus, I pray that God will deliver you. When Moses was frustrated, who did he speak to first? God, all the people. He went to God. He went to God. Think about the last few problems you were frustrated with. Who did you go to first to solve the problem? When you are frustrated, where do you go? Where do you go first before anywhere? Go back to God. Tell God your problem. In the book of Isaiah 44, verse 25, the Bible says, that frustrated the tokens of the lies and make it diviner mad, that turn wise men backward and make it their knowledge foolish. You know, frustration can make you foolish. When you are frustrated, it doesn't matter your degree, doesn't matter your education. It makes one mad to go mad. It makes one to go backward instead of going forward. The powers of frustration and backwardness, they are very strong. It doesn't matter how you are. It will make you to look foolish. That's why you need to cry this morning. Never again. Never again. Every situation that you have been facing, every situation, every frustration you have entered in, when you are being condemned, you've been brought in the court, high court, and you are condemned. You are filled. You are told you are guilty. You, the family cry. Everybody, they get sad. Or when you lose your beloved one, or somebody you love, you heard that the person is dead, or something has happened to the person. So you feel frustrated. You feel like the world is end over you. Even if you are smart, even if you are what, you feel deeply. Very frustrated. You feel so bad. You can't move forward. You can't move. You just stay there. You get frustrated. Here is the marriage. You were very happy couple. Now the marriage is breaking up. People are frustrated. You can't move forward. You are in the court. You waste time, money. So you don't move forward. Here is the job that you have been lying on. You have been fired. So you have no alternative. You can't go forward. You can't go. You can't move. You can't do anything. You are there. I pray that every power that has been frustrating you to make you to go backward, let this power be destroyed in Jesus' name. I pray that God Almighty will stand against the enemy that make you to be frustrated. In the mighty name of Jesus, we are going to pray. And you call every problem you know. We are going to pray machine gun prayer bullet. We are going to pray like machine gun. We are going to send the bullet to the problem that you are facing this morning. As you know, as I said, that I said this time 1 week to pray and seek God and destroy anything that is holding you. As tomorrow is my party day, tomorrow 20th is my party day. As I'm going to celebrate and dance to God and be happy, let you also be happy and rejoice with me. Any problem that you are facing, tomorrow, many people, you are going to wake up with a miracle. Even today before the day ends, some of you will have miracles. One lady was saying in the Periscope, she has never been sleeping. But since we started this prayer, she sleeps like a baby. She has been battling, struggling, bad dreams. Wherever she goes to bed, she can't sleep. But we thank God that God is deliver people. And more other people are coming. Another man told me that He was listening to the video. He's not in Periscope. But when he listened to the videos, he was healed. Something which was bothering for years and months. He has been visiting so many doctors, but he was still being worried about the problem that he was in. So through the videos, through the Periscope, people have testimony. Tomorrow you will have more testimony. Even me, I have already a big testimony right now. I'll share to you tomorrow. God is God. Tomorrow is going to be like what the Elisha told the king. Tomorrow in Samaria, the price is going to be reduced to 1 penny, 10 cents. And then the king says, that man, not the king, the administration of the king said, maybe if God can open heaven from even God can open windows from heaven. So as I'm telling you, God is able to deliver you, and that problem, it will never come back again. It will never come back again. As you believe that this prayer, it works. This prayer is works. Invite your people, invite your friends, share. The prayers work. If you doubt them, then it won't work for you. These words, remember, words are very, very powerful. The words that you pronounce from your mouth is very powerful. You will say amen. And if you can confess by your own mouth, that's fine. When you say, I declare again to an any bad experience I have had in my life, you shall not repeat yourself in the name of Jesus. You pray any bad experience you have had in your life, any bad experience. The first marriage you entered, it didn't work. It didn't work. So you pray that never again when you get the second marriage, you command that marriage never again, never, 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 never again happen. Never again repeat yourself in Jesus' name. You just speak like that because it's so frustration. It's so frustrated. I'm telling you, a church, Amhan had a big church, and one day, the elders of the church and the other congregation decided to move the church. They moved the whole church when they because they were conspiring. The pastor didn't know. Now, when pastor was going to the church, he found the church closed. The lock, big rock in the door. So he said, "What happened?" The pastor was crossing. The pastor started crying. He called the elders. He called people. Nobody was answering the phone. My brother was one of them. That's the little story I'm telling you. Even one time I went there and I did a lot in that church. So one day they decided to do that they do that the thing to the pastor. So then my brother came and found the pastor crying and saying, "What is this? What is going on?" And then the people he had the people in next, not far from him. They were all of the church, the congregation, all they have gone there, they started the church. So what the pastor did, he boiled the oil on the door and they talked to that lock and they said, "You the lock, never again, never, never, never again be used in this church to lock you in Jesus' name." He talked to the building, "You the building, never, 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 never again release people from this church." You see, that is a spiritual thing. He talked to the building, he talked to the ground, he talked to the house, he talked to the atmosphere, he talks to everything in that field. So he went in, they break the lock and enter in. So they started praying, they started thanking God, they started praying and dressing up and praying never again come back to this place again. So 1 week they were honoring my brother and him, two people. Then next Sunday they came back. The wife of my brothers and people, they were like 10 people. Then after 1 month, people went away. Most of them returned back to the church and apologized. So you can come against the prayer that never again. You have don't cry, don't stay there. It is frustrated, but you have to stand against them. You have to stand against that problem. You say, "I declare never again to any bad experience I have had in my life. You shall not repeat yourself again in the name of Jesus. Never again, never again, never again." Pray, say, "Never again, you that problem that came to me, never again, never repeat yourself again." If it is sickness, accident, that the people, there's some problem that come every time. You pray again, it comes back. You have to cry like that. Never again repeat yourself in Jesus' name. Repeated oppression, die by fire. die in the name of Jesus. Every repeated oppression, every repeated sickness in my life, I command you never again. I pray that every sickness, anything that is coming back again to oppress you, I pray never again. Never again in the name of Jesus. Are you tired to give me hearts? I need more hearts. I know you are praying. I know it is very, it's very bad. Yes, it is really bad. You know, problem has been facing you. It has been repeated you. That's why my sister Treasure and the rest of the people, you have to declare never again. Never, never, never again in your lifetime that problem to repeat itself again in the name of Jesus. I know people, most of you, right now you feel like you are coming mad. You must be mad with your that situation you are facing. You have to shout and declare, never again, again. Never come back to my life in Jesus' name. You pray like this. I rewrite my family history by fire. In the name of Jesus, you have to write your family history. If your family have never gone further, or your family, they have been sick, same sickness, you will rewrite your story. You will never contact that sickness. You will never have that problem again. Never again. If it is cancer killing people in your family, you declare, you tell this cancer, you cancer, never, 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 never again locate my family. Never again locate me. Never again come back to my life in Jesus' name. If it is poverty, your family background is poverty or alcoholic. Some family, they are being affected with alcohol. You find family, they drink alcoholic drugs. You name them. You command them, you alcoholic in my family, in my bloodline. I never, 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 never again to attack my children. Never again enter into my life. Never again come to my life in Jesus' name. All this is frustration. Family who are being addicted with the alcohol, drugs, some other issues. Even witchcraft, there's family with witchcraft. So if you've been saved up from the witchcraft family, you command those witchcraft never, never again to attack my children. Never again. So if you were thief and you got saved, and now you feel like all the time your eyes, you can't stop. You feel like you are still stealing, or you are fornicating, you are doing something which you need to stop. It comes back to you. It is not you. It is the powers of the enemy forcing you that thing to come. So you will name them. You will call that thing. You say, you fornication. You fornicator. You demon. I would never, 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 never come back to me. Even you can own your organ. You can own your body. You feel people, I'm telling you, this is the truth. People are going to church, but they do fornicator. They are fornicators. They can't stop. It is not them. Pastors, you see, a pastor committed suicide because of fornication. This problem, if he knows this prayer, he will say, never, 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 never again repeat yourself. So you can tell the problem that you are facing, never again. Never, 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 never repeat yourself. Never, never come back to me again in the name of Jesus. You can bring your oil and talk. I'm telling you, I'm helping you. Some people, they can't stop doing some things. Yeah? You can take a step of faith, get oil, anoint yourself, drink that oil a little bit, and speak the word. Tell the enemy, the powers that is controlling you, that you cannot be able to stop. It comes again and again. So you tell them, you listen to me. Listen, today I declare war against you. Never again. Never, 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 never. I never see you again in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus Christ. Affliction, hear the word of the Lord. Never again. You never again rest. In the name of Jesus, affliction, like sickness, you command that sickness, you sickness, never again repeat yourself, never again rise up against me, never again. Any sickness in your body, tell that sickness, never again rise up against me in Jesus' name. You pray like that, hallelujah, praise be the name of Jesus. Demonic powers assigned to use me as a footmate, I cry against you, never again, never, 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 never again in Jesus' name. You cry like that. You know there's demonic powers assigned to use people like footmat. They don't recognize you. They despise you. They disrespect you. They walk on you like a footmat. In the spiritual world, they just step on you. Do you know that people, they can step on you and walk on you? People walk on others. They don't recognize them. They don't even want to see. They don't even want to look at somebody. They just walk on you. They disrespect you. They don't even see you like you are anything. They use like a mat, like footmat. You command them never again. If there's anybody who disrespects you, who despise you, who doesn't care about you, say like this: never again, not with me. Never again use me as a footmat. Never again walk on me in Jesus' name. You talk with the third problem. If in case you have been disrespected, nobody recognize you. Even if you do anything good, nobody saying thank you. Don't worry. Say you. Never again, never, 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 never again. That's how you deal with it, the spirit of frustration and backwardness. Because it makes one to be going backward instead of going forward. So you cry, you stop. Moses cried to the problem. And this problem was simple. He could have stand and rebuke them. But it took him time to cry and bitter and frustrated. So any problem that wants to frustrate you, talk to them. Talk to that problem. You say, you, the problem you have come. I command you, by the power and the blood of Jesus, never again appear to me. Never again come to me in the name of Jesus. I destroy you. I bind you. I command you. I set you fire in the name of Jesus. Spirit of blessing and loose, I cry against you. Never again in the name of Jesus. There's some spirit of blessing. You can get blessed today. Tomorrow, you lose everything. So those are the powers of frustration and backwardness. Instead of going back forward, now the spirit, the spirit of frustration come and take the blessings of God. Every blessing you got, it take away. You lose everything. Therefore, you pray, every power that has been sent by the devil to frustrate me, to take away my boyfriend, to take away my wife, my girlfriend, to take away my the star of my bread, I never again, never again, never again, never again. They come and take away your job. You command them, never again. You lose your job. You lose good things. Never again repeat yourself. Never, 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 never again. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Frustration and backwardness are signed against you. I cry against you. Never again in the name of Jesus. Every frustration and backwardness are signed against your life, are signed against your family. Your family can be frustrated. Your family can be backwardness. Instead of going forward, the whole family will be stagnant. It will be standstill. They could not do anything. They can't do anything because of frustration and has entered in the family. Look at all the children of Israel. They were like 3 million, as the Bible says. There were more with children, but they were standing, and Moses cried, said, "These people want to stone me. I don't know what to do." Everything was standstill. Nobody was moving. They were standing and asking Moses question: "Did you bring us to the wilderness to die in thirst and our cattle?" Even they were concerned about the animals. Now Moses, when Moses looked at the situation, he started crying. So there's some situation that will make you can't move. You can't do anything. You will stand crying. Stop crying. God knows you. God understands what you are going through. Therefore, people of God, command the problem, never again repeat yourself. Never again frustration and backward. Assign against me, assign against my life, assign against my children, assign against me. Never again, never again, never again, never, 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 never again. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. The lion of past problems roaring against you, I command them to shut up. Be silent in Jesus' name. The Bible tells us in the book of James, the lion roaring to deceive somebody, but it's not a lion, it's a satanic lion that is roaring to devour somebody. But in the name of Jesus, that voice scare you, take away good things from you, cry against it. Never again, be shut up and be silent. Never again repeat yourself in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Yes, my God. Jesus, we love you. Jesus, we thank you, my God. We love you, Jesus. In the name of Jesus, visitation of merchandise of death, die in the name of Jesus. Visitation of merchandise of death, I cry against you. Die in the name of Jesus. Satanic embarrassment, I cry you against you. Never again in the name of Jesus. You command satanic embarrassment. You say satanic embarrassment, I cry against you. Never again in the name of Jesus. So when you pray that, like the prayers that my father was praying, that never again, never again, never again, my father in the Lord was praying these prayers. He was praying these prayers. He's the one who sent these prayers to me. So I prayed the same. A satanic embarrassment, I cry against you. Never again. Never, 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 never again. You commanded them. You've been embarrassed enough. So you are not going to be embarrassed anymore. You cry and declare them. They shall never repeat yourself. In the name of Jesus Christ. Everything, hear the word of God. Everything, hear the word of the Lord. Turn around for my favor. In the name of Jesus. Everything had the ear. You command them to turn around for your favor. In the name of Jesus. My God and my Father, I want to thank you, Jesus. I want to bless your name. I know that God is able to deliver you from never again, to deliver you from every problem and situation that you are facing in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, my Father, I want to thank you, Jesus. I pray that God, Moses cried. So you are not going to cry that you have been crying for the situation. You have been frustrated and you have nowhere to go, nowhere to turn to. Sometimes you are being shocked. Things are happening. You don't know where to go. You don't know where to move to. You are like, what can I do? The good news is that condemn them. The Bible says, no weapon formed against you shall prosper. If they come, condemn them. You have been given a mouth. You have been given what? The Bible has around you condemn them. Don't be afraid. Condemn the issues. Don't be afraid to condemn the enemy that is attacking you. You come against them and you condemn them. You command them never again repeat yourself. Never again repeat yourself in the name of Jesus. I pray that God will deliver you. God will take care of your problem. God will see you through. You will move forward. Never again move backward in the name of Jesus. I thank God that God will help you in the name of Jesus Christ. Go to our website, www.overcomersdhministry.blogspot.ca and donate good amount and donate an amount that you want to donate to our ministry. God will help you. We are celebrating tomorrow our anniversary and my birthday, so I wish that you come, everyone, to celebrate with us. Therefore, go to our website and you can donate an amount. You can donate. God will bless you this time that we are praying, and God will help you. Also, if you are standing, you have prayer, you need prayers. You see, these prayers, since I started, I got a lot of calls than before. Yesterday, there was a lady, she just came in, and she found the prayer was going on. She started calling. Sure, I prayed with her, and God will help her in the name of Jesus. Share these videos with your friends, with your family. These videos is going to help you. Take time by yourself. Condemn every problem that you are facing. Tell them never again, come back again to me. Declare a war against frustration and backwardness in the name of Jesus. Call us. Our number is 905-487-7196. That is our number. Also, we have a cell phone. You can text us, because many people, they have cell phone now. You can WhatsApp. You can go to Skype. You can reach us anyway. If you have a family in another country, Africa, wherever, you can give them their cell phone number, 647-608-5207. Thank you very much. God bless you. My sister, Treasure, thank you, thank you. Yes, this is the number that you can reach. You can reach me. Also, you can share. You can give the number to people who need to come and join, to come and pray with us. And also, we have a class. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. The class for deliverance and the class for training, deliverance training school. This class has changed many lives. Tomorrow you are going to hear some people, all Friday, Saturday, Sunday, students who have gone through that class. You will hear their testimony. they will give testimony what they have learned and what they have God has changed their life. This class is very important. Go to our website. You will see news and events. You see a school, Overcomers Deliverance Training School. Click there and read the rules there. Some people, they don't see. They call me and ask me. They don't see the website. When you open the website like this, the first page, you will see news and events. That's when you click there. You see the, what the requirement is. You call me. I will teach you one-on-one. It is a class. It's a class, and I thank God that God has given me more people, and I want to reach you. It doesn't matter. Your time, anytime you want me to teach you, I am here. I am a teacher. I used to have my own school, and still God is calling me to have a school. This school is going to change in the future to become a university, to become a big school. Yesterday, my lecturer called me. He called me because he said, "Christine, I want to meet you and see how we can work together." I said, "Wow, this is good." So I pray that the university will link with this program. Then that is it. You will get a certificate, you will get a diploma, you will get a university degree. If you can study this, you will study slowly. Then at the end, you will get credit certificate, and then you can get a job out of this. And also we train. Yesterday, my lecturer was telling me that we need to think about chaplain training school. Also, if you want to work in prison as a chaplain, and the hospital, also, he was telling me, I am making plans to go and see him next week and see what course he wants to recommend us to go on. And he will teach also. He's my professor in the university, so he's a very good professor. And also, God is good. God is good. I'm telling you, this training will change your life. And I have people behind me who will help you to change your life. I'm not alone. Therefore, people of God, I thank you for so much. God says we are starting slowly, small, but we are growing. I'm telling you that the people who calls me, they are not in Periscope, they are not in Twitter, but they hear the videos. And the videos have changed their life. Therefore, people of God, I want to thank God for your life. You are not here in Periscope for fair. God will bless you and change your life in Jesus' name. Receive your miracles in the mighty name of Jesus. Anything you are looking, any prayer point, any prayer that you are praying, asking God, let God meet it. Let God bless you and receive it in Jesus' name. I thank God and I pray that God will meet your needs in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you very much. See you 1 o'clock. God bless you and have a wonderful time. And in the name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. Thank you. Bye-bye. Bye.